good morning or good afternoon, whenever it is. I come to you with a double helping of Steely Dan for Steely Sunday. Hopefully that'll do for this Memorial Day weekend. Let's do it. Hi guys, welcome to LibreX. Hope everyone's having a good day. I know I am. I'm doing all right. We are back, of course, with our weekly Steely Dan video. And this week we have a request. Wow, that's crazy. Thank you to our patron, Patrick M., for sending this in. We're actually going to be doing two tracks, like I said. One off of Can't Buy a Thrill and one off of Pretzel Logic. The second one is off Pretzel Logic, and it's actually a cover of Duke Ellington and Bubba Miley's song East St. Louis, Toodle-Oo. And then the other one is Midnite Cruiser off of Can't Buy a Thrill. So that one's first, and then Pretzel Logic song. Let's do it. And if y'all want to watch some more Dan, right there. There you go. I got a whole playlist. We do this every Sunday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Be in the chat. Hang out with us. We have a good time. We really do. All right. First up, Midnight Cruiser off of Can't Buy a Thrill by Steely Dan. 3, 2, 1, hit it. Jim Hodder on the vocals. Where is your bounty of fortune and fame? I am another gentleman loser. Drive me to Harlem or somewhere the same. I love the mood of this. That hand percussion is so good. The world that we used to know, people tell me it don't turn no more. The places we used to go, familiar faces that ain't smiling like before. The time of our time is come. Harmony's really pretty. That one's Denny, right? They're both playing, but... That's tight. That sounds like skunk. Such a good progression. Wow. That was really good. Jim killed that on the vocals. And he was drumming too. That's great, dude. All right, so now we're going to Pretzel Logic. It's right here. Walter uses a talk box on this. Peter? Does replicate that swampy sound very well. Wow, this is so different for them. I know it's a cover, but damn. Get it, Donald. Ooh. Wow. Got a dark feeling to it. And the fucking gong to end it. And that's how they ended side one of that album, too. Ricky, don't lose that number. Oh, man. Well, that was great. I really like the first one, too. I like the second one as well, but the first one, I really like Jim's vocals on that. I think Donald obviously was singing, like, the harmony with him, but he really killed that. And, like, he was still, like, doing his fills perfectly, and, like, you know, it was kind of just, like, a straight rhythm song, but he had a couple, yeah, fills he just got in there with it. But, yeah, his vocals were great, and I think he balanced out the song in a way that Donald usually doesn't with his vocals, because his vocals are very... dramatized or stylized, whatever you want to call it. He has like a more straightforward kind of vocal approach, it seems like, and I think he did a really good job with that. He still did the, you know, Steely Dan talking about something dirty in New York, you know, sort of thing. He did a great job, I thought. I really liked the piano and the guitar, obviously, in that too. Donald, Skunk, and Denny, right? Yeah, Denny and Skunk are... See, I always come back to this question of, do I like them better as a band, or do I like them better with the two and then the session musicians? Because some of this older stuff is just so tight. Like Midnite Cruiser, that was a tight-ass song, dude. That was really, really good. Like, every person had a moment to shine other than Walter, like on the bass. I didn't really hear as much from him. I did hear him kind of playing off Jim at some points, but for the most part, the sound was dominated by the guitars and the piano and the vocals. But for the second one, it felt like a hybrid of like this I don't even know, it's like this evil carnival 1920s like swing jazz, I don't know, gone bad situation. I don't know. It's very strange. But I know it's a cover like of a Duke Ellington song, but they, as Patrick put it in his request message, they Steely Danified it. They definitely did. But I'd never heard anything like that from them. It was very different. It was very almost, what's the word? I always forget this word. Why do I always forget this word? I don't know. It's mysterious. It's very not enigmatic. Fuck Lou. I always forget this word. And I'll remember it later. Abstract. There we go. It's abstract. It's kind of like an abstract kind of song. But it has the very interesting dichotomy of the talk box. But that strange electric piano that Donald's doing too. And it just bounces off each other really well. And I think they balanced each other out really well in that song. But it was very creepy at points. I really liked it. That was really cool. That was a good combo of songs, Patrick. Thank you for that. I don't know. If I had to pick anything from both of them, I guess Jim's vocals and then the two lead guitars, you know, Denny and Skunk in the first song. But then I guess that creepy piano and the talk box in the second one, man, that was creepy. I really liked it, though. Like, they replicated that, like, swampy kind of bluesy sound perfectly with the talk box. That's great. And it didn't even really sound like how Frampton uses it. Frampton, like, I don't know how to explain it, but he uses it kind of differently than Walter did there. So it's the same lineup for... Yeah, Donald, Walter, Jeff, Denny, and Jim. And then the additional musicians. Dean Parks did the banjo on this song. And Roger Nichols hit the gong once. And then for that one, that was track what? Track 4. It does not look like there's anything special other than Jim was the vocals for it. So that was... David Palmer was doing backing vocals at one point. But Donald Fagen, obviously, Denny, Walter, and Jeff. Yep, same lineup, and no extra musicians. So yeah, but if I had to pick between the two, that's kind of hard. I would probably have to go with Midnite Cruiser, but I really did like the East St. Louis Toodle-Oo. That was really cool. Very creepy. Like, I plan on listening to that again. I don't know why I always forget the word abstract. Like, I always do. Like, I'll freeze on camera and be like, what is it? And it's always the same word. It's always abstract. And it's funny that the word abstract is the word I can never remember. There's something abstract about that. But yeah, that was great. Thank you so much for sending those in, Patrick. Like I said, I usually am just picking the Steely Dan videos because no one sends in requests for them. Because I guess they already know I'm going to do them anyway. So they're like, fuck it, let them do it. You'll get to it eventually. But I really appreciate you, brother. Thank you. That was great. That was a great combo of songs. They paired well together. They really did. I think that's it, though. Thank you for joining me for another Steely Sunday, my friends. Hopefully that'll give you a nice start to your day if you're watching Dave Premiere. If you're watching this 3 years down the line, well then, hello. Hopefully the world's still not on fire. And yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. If y'all know, we have a Patreon right there. There's a picture of it. No, you damn AI camera. There's a link in the description. If you join the $15 tier or up, you get one free request a month. If you join any of the tiers, you get access to all of our blocked videos and full album reactions. In our Discord server, there is all kinds of perks and benefits for all the different tiers. We'd love to have you. We have a great community. I think we're almost at like 500 people now. That's crazy, man. I remember when there was like 30 and like half of them paid. You know what I'm saying? And now we're just kind of growing every day, man. And I'm very grateful. And I might be moving soon, you know, into my girl's house so I can be with the girls and stuff. And it's going to be a dream come true. And I'm very excited. Hopefully everything goes well. It's a hard time still, but we're going to get through it together. And now I'll be even closer. I won't be, getting dropped off at night. So I might have to change things around. I don't know. I'll have to find like a place to record there, obviously. Like, I can record outside, out in the living room, but I'll figure something out. I might make a little studio in the house somewhere. But I think that's it, guys. There's also a PayPal link as well in the description if you wanted to leave a tip or send a request in that way. That's the best way to do it. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see y'all later.